So welcome again in this you know, too much there is heat over there. We are sweating and the atmosphere is full of moisture. Let's enjoy our next session for organs of government. As I have earlier told you in my last session too, that this is the most important session. Your lesson, your chapter, your whatever you understand in your own languages, it's an important one. So organs of government, we were going through the chapter number 10, and we had seen that legislature, executive and judiciary, three sections are there, and they have been given some particular types of powers to maintain the government, to maintain the rules and regulations, very many many things regarding, as the India is a democratic country, for the people, by the people, of the people. The government is of the people, by the people, and for the people. You might have studied these three words. It will be helpful in through of your life. Let's continue the principle of division of power, how they are being divided. You are given given power in different stages. So number one is legislature. India is a republic having a parliamentary democracy. The representation of the people at the center is seen at the parliament, and of the state is seen in the legislative assembly. The parliament is an important and apex organization of the nation. The Indian parliament consists of the president, the vice president, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha legislature is of two type. So we are going through number one, legislature. It is in you can find that Gujarati Hindi word from your parents too, yeah, go through any dictionary. I would not repeat this thing in my video, but the first session is of the parliament. We can see parliament. Yes, I have written here this. No, sorry, this. Parliament, a house situated in Delhi, our central government, we can say. We people, the people who got the right to vote, means above 18, elect representatives for the Parliament of India. Somewhere it is written MP, member of parliament, like this. You might have seen on some boards, yeah, offices, yeah, on some vehicles to MP, member of parliament, like this. Means such people are elected by the, sorry, such members of parliament are elected by the people, and we used to send our representative to the government. A person we elect and send him or her as the member of parliament for government. Till yet you might have understood. Here again I would like to repeat the first one. The legislature, India is a republic having a parliamentary democracy. Parliamentary, a house, a particular place, we can say, where the members of the parliaments are elected. Apart, the representation of the people at the center is seen at the parliament, and of the state is seen in the legislative assembly. So in both sections, state level government, they are called that place is called legislative assembly. Why? At the central level, it is called parliament. So representative, as earlier I told, we are
sending our represent, we are electing by giving them vote from any party. A particular person, as we think, yes, he is a good person. That he can work in the government for the. Understood till here? Two sections are there: parliament and the legislative assembly. Two, legislative assembly is in a particular state, and parliament is in the central level. So, the parliament is an important and apex organization of the nation. It's apex and important organizations. A particular organization that is called parliament, and it is of and for the nation. The Indian parliament consists of the president, the vice president, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. These two are the houses of government. Legislature is of two types. Now we are going to legislature. What is legislature? Number one is unicameral legislature. When the legislature is consisting of one house, it is called unicameral legislature. Why bicameral legislature? When the legislature is consisting of two houses, is called a bicameral legislature. This point, it will confuse you. That again legislature means government is having two houses, particular one house and second house two. For example, you are owning two houses. So some member of your family will live in this house, some will live in, yeah, in other section we can say, if you are having a joint family living in one particular house, then it is called unicameral legislature. And if you are having your family members are living in different house, then it is called bicameral legislature. This topic will come thoroughly in the next part. Then you will come to know what is unicameral and what is bicameral. So let's begin. Let's go for it. At the central level, the upper house of the legislature is called the Rajya Sabha, and the lower house is called the Lok Sabha. At the state level, the legislature consists of the legislative assembly and legislative council too. Most of the states have only legislative assembly states, like Bihar, Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra have legislative councils too. So how this happens? What is Lok Sabha and what is lower house? I would like to know, if you don't mind. Thank you. So now make you understand. Legislature, yes, you know, it's an organ of government. Means we can say it's, for example, government. Now at the central level, we are having parliament. Parliament, not parliament, P-A-R-L-A. So, in parliament, there are two sections. One is Rajya Sabha. At the central level, I am talking about the government of India. Central level. There are two houses. One is Rajya Sabha and other is Lok Sabha. Then we will go in deeper. To make you understand, I will, no doubt I will go through it. Then at the state level also, maximum states are having legislative assemblies, and in some state there are two. One is legislative assembly and legislative councils. Example: UP, Bihar, Maharashtra. They are having legislative council too. Why this? No doubt, it's the government of India. So to rule over the whole country, there it has been divided into two sections. One is Rajya Sabha and one is Lok Sabha. We can understand that the whole country consists of this thing. The government of the whole country is worked by these two, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. It is called Parliament, Parliament House. There are two sections, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Why? But why at the state level it is? Legislative Council and Legislative Assembly. Every state has a Legislative Assembly. We can say a particular house, a particular section, just like that is of Parliament. At state level we are having Legislative Assembly, but why in other states like UP, Bihar and Maharashtra we are having Legislative Councils too? Why it is so? Because these states are bigger in size. So there are lots and lots of members. And to run the government of the bigger states, we are having two houses, we can say. One is Legislative Assembly and another is Legislative Council. So, my dear friends, you can understand that. There is no complication. Don't be confused about this thing. Nothing to be confused. Just you go through this thing. Try to understand, because we are going through the organs of the government. You must know this thing, that what is there, which, how our government is formed. What are, who are the persons sitting over there? As we go through the news, this minister, that minister, Narendra Modi, Prime Minister, yeah, Vijay Rupani, from a Chief Minister of Gujarat. So why these differentiate things are there? Why these all things? We are having a government. And from that, the first question is, for example, we will take legislature as a government. And to maintain this thing, two, we are having parliament. And in parliament, there are two houses, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Just like at that, this is from the central level. The members here are from all India. Members from all the part of it. Understood? This parliament consists, yeah, this both house consist members from all the part of India. Why? Yeah, this is the state level government. It is also, in some states are having both the houses, Legislative Council and Legislative Assembly too. most of the states are having only and only as legislative assembly. Small states like Gujarat, etc., Rajasthan, we can say. But to maintain, yet to part the work, their division of work, as these all are big states. For the division of work, why division of work? To maintain this thing, legislature, to maintain the government, for the ruling of government, we can say there are two parts at the state level also, as they are having the part at the central level. We are having the part of this parliament, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Just like at the same system is done over there in the state level too. That the state level government consists of legislative council and legislative assembly. Only few states are there. 3, 4, or 5 states are there. Those are having member of legislative council. Yeah, there is a legislative council because they are huge, yeah, big states. So, in Gujarat, we are having only legislative assembly. Only these governments, these members that we elect from Gujarat. If a member from Bihar, UP or Maharashtra, any state, he cannot be the member of this our Gujarat state. So only we write Gujarat. Understood? Here, the members are from all India. They are elected from the whole India. Even from Andaman and Nicobar. Even from Lakshadweep Island. Understood? This we are having our state government, while we are having this central government. So members from different states, different regions are working over here. While here in a state level government, we are having two houses, legislative assembly and legislative council, and we are having members from Gujarat. Understood properly? Legislature, parliament. If you go to the central level, there is parliament, there is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Here, legislature and state government, legislative council and legislative assembly and legislative council for the bigger states. I would like to continue. I think so. You might have understood this properly, that these sections are there regarding the government. Now, legislature, pay on page number 74. Legislature at the central level, parliament, Lok Sabha. What the Lok Sabha is and how does it work? So, let's be with Lok Sabha. It's an important thing. It is at the central level. Understand this. Lok Sabha at the central level. Now we are going to go through legislature. This one at the central level, this one, and it's a parliament, this one, and that is Lok Sabha. Now we are going with Lok Sabha. It doesn't look good, so I would like to rub something. Okay. So legislature. Yeah. It is at central level. Just for your information, I am writing central level. parliament. And from one house, that is looks. So Lok Sabha is a, yes, it's also called lower house. Lok Sabha is also called lower house, and Rajya Sabha is called upper house. Why Rajya Sabha is called upper house and Lok Sabha is called lower house? Rajya Sabha means all Raja might be working over there. Do you feel like this? All Rajas will be there, as it is Rajya Sabha. And here Lok Sabha means all Loko, simple Loks will be there. Is it so? No, it's not like this. Why? It will be continued afterwards. I will explain it to you properly. Why upper house, lower house? Before that, who are there? And what is parliament? What is Lok Sabha? Let's go. Lok Sabha is the lower house of the parliament. The members of the Lok Sabha are the representatives of the people who are elected through direct election. There are in all 545 members of the Lok Sabha. Out of 545 members, 2 members are selected by the president for the Anglo-Indian community. President from the Anglo-Indian. So we are having in this Lok Sabha 545 members elected by us people of India. From these 2 minus 2, 543 we are elected. Why 2 members are elected by the President of India from Anglo-Indian community? What is Anglo-Indian community? There is a particular community. For example, a foreigner person, he marries Indian girl, yeah, Indian boy, and settled over here in India. No doubt he becomes Indian. But there is a certain community, as we are having different communities. For example, Hindus are there, Muslims are there, Sikhs are there, Jains are there. Such a type of people are Anglo-Indians also. So from that community, 2 members of this Lok Sabha are elected by President of India. So we can understand that from 545, 543 members we get from election by the people. This election is throughout the India, from different districts,
from different states, from different talukas, from different we can say areas. Particular area is derived over there, particular locations are given for them, and then there is elections of the parliament, and we people used to select these our representatives to perform to make a government. So till yet you all might have understood this thing, try to read it. We are having legislature, we are having parliament within that, we are having two houses at the central level, means at the parliament, upper house and lower house. What are they? Upper house is Rajya Sabha, lower house is Lok Sabha. Then we are having at the state level legislative assembly, legislative councils are there for few states, those states are bigger one, we are having legislative councils too. Yet you might have understood in this thing, we were going through the legislative, then central government, in parliament, these two houses are there, 545 members are there, it is called lower house. Among them, two members are elected by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. Two members are elected, other 543 members are there. Those who are elected by us, means by people of India through elections. Till this thing you all might have understood. I will continue this thing from my next session. Slowly we will move towards this lesson as it is important one. If any doubt regarding, I think so there will be no doubt as you all are genius. So if you have any doubt, just you can say to me, yeah, you can go through Deepak sir too. So my dear students, till then, take care, be happy, enjoy your life, but be conscious of this Corona 19 or COVID 19 or novel coronavirus, as it is spreading more and more day by day. So please, it's kind request, take precautions and eat healthy, nutritious food, not junk food. Don't go anywhere here and there, be with your parents, be at home, go to your studies. As I told, 6 hours you needed to be with your books, improve your English, improve your math, science, every subject. And thank you very much.